Hey folks, welcome to IGA Tech Dive. I'm Jim Montgomery, the Governance Practice Lead with TriVir, an open text partner specializing in advisory and implementation services in the identity and access management realm. Today in the world of identity governance administration, we will talk about birthright provisioning. This is how you grant new hires an initial set of access very quickly. Let's get started and look at the business goal. As a security administrator, you would use birthright provisioning so that you can get new employees and staff the access they need to start their job. Birthright is about the initial access during onboarding of new identities. The good news is that the IG software handles not only birthright provisioning, but it also uses the same mechanism to handle provisioning and deprovisioning of access during the whole lifecycle of a user. Let's look at how you implement this. Birthright is really a subset of business roles. I encourage you to watch my video about business roles or read more about it in the documentation. You could use department-based, title-based, location, or supervisor-based business roles to specify what new employees should get. You might have some permissions that every active employee should receive, so you can create a business role for that. And usually this is a good place to start if you have birthright in mind. However, if you expand birthright and start categorizing what permissions certain titles or employees in certain departments should have, well, then you are setting yourself up for automation across the life of the user, not just at hire time. Let's set up a business role for any employee with active status. Create a new business role. We'll just call this active employees. I'm going to use a membership expression, and I want the employee status to match active. I'm going to save this. It's warning me that I haven't done SOD analysis, but I don't have any SOD rules at the moment. If I look at authorizations, we're going to add some permissions that all active employees should have. In this example, I'm going to arbitrarily choose this Active Directory permission. I'm going to also choose a permission access from my identity vault. How about this one? Choose to add those. So now I've set it to be mandatory that when someone is detected as an active employee, like any new employees would be, they're automatically going to get fulfillment items to grant these two permissions to them. I'm going to save this, skip my SOD analysis, and then publish this business role. So it's now active. I'm going to create a new identity in my identity store, and then we'll run a collection and publish and come back and show you what happens with the business role. All right, IG has pulled that new identity in. I did have to go back and set auto grant on my role. Let's show that the identities and scope of the business role and that the permissions were assigned. I'm going to look in the catalog under identities. This was my new user that I had marked as active. If we drill in, you'll see on this business roles tab for this particular user, they have active employees as a business role. And then if we look at permissions, you'll see that it's detected they've been granted those two groups that I made part of the business role assignment. I did have to recollect from AD and Identity Vault those applications to get these to show up in the catalog, but the fulfillment item was generated immediately. Let's summarize. To wrap up, we looked at birthright provisioning so that new hires immediately get appropriate access to begin work. And that's all for now. Thanks for joining me. If you have any questions, you can post them in the Open Text community forum or reach out to me at jmontgomery@triver.com. Thanks.